أيها المسلمون، إنه لا بد للعاقل من شيء من متاع الدنيا وزادها، يتبلغ به في سفره إلى الآخرة. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى: وابتغ فيما آتاك الله الدار الآخرة ولا تنس نصيبك من الدنيا وأحسن كما أحسن الله إليك. وكان من دعائه صلى الله عليه وسلم: اللهم أصلح لي ديني الذي هو عصمة أمري، وأصلح لي دنياي التي فيها معاشي. بل كان أكثر دعائه صلى الله عليه وسلم: ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ومن ثم فإنه ليس من شرط العمل للآخرة أن ينطوي الإنسان على نفسه ويترك إصلاح دنياه بما شرعه الله، ولكن المطلوب أن يعرف العاقل وزن دنياه فلا يعطيها أكثر مما تستحقه، وقدر آخرته فيسعى لها سعيها وهو مؤمن. O Muslims, it is necessary for the sane person to have something from the conference of this dunya, to increase in it in order to reach the next world. Allah the Exalted says, but seek through that which Allah has given you, the home of the hereafter. And yet do not forget your share of this worldly life, and do good as Allah has done good to you. Amongst his supplication, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was, O Allah, set right for me my religion, which is the safeguard of my affairs, and set right for me the affairs of the world, wherein is my living. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, rather used to supplicate Allah, saying, O our Lord, grant us the best of this life and the best of the next life, and protect us from the punishment of the fire. Hence, it is not a condition of actions for the hereafter that a person should confine himself to himself and leave this worldly affairs without attending to them, but rather he has to make sure that they are set in order. Well, what is required is for the wise person to know the weight of his worldly life, so he does not give it more than what it deserves, and knows the weight of the hereafter and gives it what it deserves.